And the Oakland Raiders won two games this season so far, both wins against teams that could have been playoff contenders. Today, they face the Buffalo Bills, a team that has improved quite a bit this season. The record is 8-6, so it will be easy to assume they will win this game. But the Raiders have improved a lot, and after beating the Chiefs and 49ers, no team should count on beating Oakland. The Oakland Raiders won their third win of the season, knocking the Buffalo Bills out of playoff contention Sunday with their big win at home. The Raiders have three straight wins in the Oakland County Coliseum, and the Raider Nation sees light at the end of the tunnel. The game started with a Buffalo touchdown, a 42-yard pass from Kyle Orton to Sammy Watkins. But the Raiders scored three times in the second quarter, a 3-yard touchdown pass from Derek Carr to James Jones, and two field goals by Sebastian Jankowski. Dan Carpenter kicked a field goal for the Bills, but at the half, the Raiders were leading 13-10. The Raiders scored two more field goals in the third quarter, and then another touchdown pass by Carr to Jamise Hollowell in the fourth, keeping ahead of the Bills, who were scoreless in the third. Buffalo had two touchdowns in the fourth, but it wasn't enough to win the game. The Raiders' defense kept the team in the game. Quarterback Derek Carr is no longer a rookie. He's making better decisions with his offense, and on Sunday, he was able to guide his team to 6 scores, 4 field goals, and 2 touchdowns. It was a tough loss for the Bills, who came off from a big win over the Packers, hoping to put themselves in a position for the playoffs. Their last game will be against the Patriots in Boston, so their final game won't be any easier. The Raiders finished their season in Denver against Peyton Manning and the Broncos. That will be a tough game, but if the Oakland defense can disrupt the Denver offense, they could upset the division leaders. This is what the players and coaches had to say today.
Well, we got to get them to play better this week. I mean, they have to understand. I mean, you know, you got to go there. People are going to be physical. You're going to be challenged every week, and you know, you have to be up for it. I mean, you know, those guys got beat.
I'll say they just kicked our ass. You know, we rushed the ball for 20 yards. We knew they were good up front. We knew they were going to try to beat us up front on both sides of the ball. We talked about it all week. We knew what we were in for. We know, you know, those guys played a lot of football in this league. They're great players. And we didn't get it done. We didn't get it done up front. And once again, we take it very personal. And, you know, we got embarrassed. And that's on us, the players. That's not on the coaches. That's not on anybody but us.
You know, I love the way that they practice. They come out there. There's no nonsense. They're all business-like, you know, and they have fun. You know, I think that's probably been the biggest change, is that we have a little bit of fun doing what we're doing right now. You know, work is not work. You know, as I told them, we got the best job in the world. So, you know, it's a fun job.
You know, we're trying to change a culture, like I said, and we are. So even though it's not been how we want it to be, we know that if we keep fighting, keep working hard, eventually it's going to get there. And so finishing out 3-0 at home, you know, finishing out the way that we can, all those things are so important in building this franchise. You know, once we were out of the playoff run, you know, it's kind of, you know, you can do one of two things. You can give in, or you can, you know, bear down and keep fighting.
Well, you know, without a doubt, you know, when you're home, you have to take advantage of, you know, this fan base, obviously, that we have. And, you know, win at home, that's important.
This is Claudia Gestro for the LA Post-Examiner.